juguetes!
Clientes especiales.
Yo he tenido bastante, me largo.
¡Adelante!
I do not know who you see, but by all that is holy, it is not me. Captain Kenway, just in time. I'll see you back aboard.
Thank you.
¡Que no se escabulla!
Thank you. Venga, no bajéis el ritmo.
En esta oportunidad.
¡Buitre! ¡Detenedlo!
¡Tengo pez espada! ¡A tres la libra!
Sorry about the swift exit. Bit of a misunderstanding.
One heaped upon another.
Oh, Jesus. I'm sorry, mate. This is my doing. I'm only trying to keep these Spanish eyes off me.
Oh, it's no bother. Regrettably, the soldiers confiscated my sugar. But when your dispatches...
Damn! And where have they gone?
Haven't the foggiest idea, I'm afraid. I suspect those chaps might, but my Spanish is wee mal dad, so I'd rather not ask.
Shit! All right, come on, let's follow them and recover my maps.
And my sugar?
What, in my drawers? We'll see what happens.
You don't mind me tagging along, do you?
Not if you keep quiet and stay out of sight.
Bonnet!
I believe I'm getting the hang of this!
Quiet!
I fear they're onto us!
Hang back.
Perhaps we should split up to confuse them.
It's the best idea you've had today.
Obsecro auxilium medico, sed et fornicatione obes reo
contendere. Vaya si usted a paseo mañana embriagado. Otro majadero veo.
¡Alto!
Buenos días, señores. You're late.
Yes, sir. Dear, we're very sorry. Our time is late.
This will be Captain Mendoza.
Yes, sir. He's very excited to meet you. Only he must be present for a hanging. Señor.
Hanging? Oh, I love a good hanging.
Yes, sir. Very nice. If we hear the bell, we may go, if you like.
Hey, para! Listo para disparar!
How long will this hanging take, man? I don't mean to hang about all day for the captain.
Quick as anything, sir. Captain Mendoza needs only to hang the man. Then he will deliver your payment.
I don't want the alleys, mind. I want goods. Things I can sell. Tobacco, rum, sugar.
See, we have much fine sugar. Great, we took off a fat Englishman last night.
Englishman?
Por el delito de motín contra tu capitán, el
sí.
Tribunal te sentencia a morir en la
horca. Very fine. We hold it in the Castillo after the man started the fight last night. He ran, left his sugar behind. Very fine.
Well, that's a start. Shall I accompany him to the Castillo?
No, sir. Captain Mendoza will have it sent to you, I believe. You will see.
Good Lord. That big brute, your Captain Mendoza.
No, sir. He is El Tiburón. El Tiburón, Governor Torres' man.
Remember me.
¿Crees que puedes despistarnos?
Debería haberlo pensado mejor.
Thank you.
Sorry about the sugar. I've only one pair of hands.
Oh, it's no great loss. I've got plenty of cargo here to make a profit on my trip.
Will you stay here long?
For a few weeks, yes. Then back to Barbados, to the tedium of domesticity.
Don't settle for tedium. Sail for Nassau. Live life as you see fit.
Haven't I heard that Nassau is crawling with pirates? Seems a very tawdry place.
Not tawdry, liberated.
Oh, God. That would be an adventure. But no. No, I'm a husband and a father. I have responsibilities. Life can't be all pleasure and distraction, Duncan.
Hey, our bonnet. The name's Edward, in truth. Duncan's only a handle.
Ah. Secret name for your secret meeting with the governor.
The governor, right. I think I've kept him waiting long enough.
Pirate! Pirate!
guardia del tridente.
Buenos dias. Mr. Duncan Walpole of England to see the governor. I believe he is expecting me.
Sí, señor Walpole. Entre, por favor. ¿Ese es el hombre? El... ¿cómo lo llamabas? ¿Asesino?
Sí, Duncan Walpole. Debería haber llegado hace muchos días.
No me gusta que los extranjeros se paseen por nuestra ciudad. No me fío de ellos.
Cállate. El gobernador tiene invitados. Todos franceses e ingleses.
Parece un hombre rudo. Le suponía un aspecto más respetable.
Lleva meses en alta mar. Sé indulgente con él.
Good morning, sir. Would I be correct in thinking you are...
I am indeed.
I thought as much. Woods Rogers.
A pleasure.
The same. I must say, my wife has a terrible eye for description.
I'm sorry.
My wife. You met her some years ago at the Percy's Masquerade Ball.
Ah, quite.
She called you devilishly handsome. Obviously, a lie to stoke my jealousy. Julianne, our guest of honor has arrived, Mr. Duncan Walpole.
Julianne Ducasse. I hope your conversion to our order is an honest one. I have no love for assassins, but even less for liars.
I have not come to disappoint.
Up for a bit of sport, Duncan? The old man isn't ready just yet.
You've got my two best pairs of matched pistols, Duncan, so handle them with care.
If I had eight, I'd treat each as my own son.
Pull off a few shots if you like. Get a feel for it.
I once fought beside a man who carried nine on his person. They were a boon in battle, but hindered his ability to swim. Sadly.
Quite. Good kick, yes?
I long for the day where one...
on something extraordinary.
Magnifique!
All right. Here's a simple challenge. Try to strike every target before this hourglass empties. Remember, hit every target within the... Bad luck. Try again.
Duncan, where are your wrist blades? I've never seen an assassin so ill-equipped.
Ah, damaged, sadly, beyond all repair.
Have your choice.
Where did you find all these?
I did not find them. I took them. These are souvenirs. Two blades, as is the custom, eh?
Custom, aye.
Duncan, will you indulge us with a demonstration of your techniques?
Well,
We must. We put together a training course in anticipation of your arrival. It would be a shame to leave here without seeing you in action.
Yes, of course. Well, I mean, if there is time, I would gladly, show you what I know.
Here. You see? Situations well suited to your skills.
Have a go. A blade in a crowd is always the simplest. Nothing grandiose, just quick and clean.
Show us another technique.
Quite ingenious to use bales of hay for cover, don't you think? The spirit? Secrecy. The advantage of surprise cannot be overstated, isn't that so? Especially around a blind corner. God blind me, that's a clever trick.
Your aerial kills have a poetic beauty. Despite their conspicuous quality, would you show us?
Magnifique. Is it also possible to deliver a killing blow at high speed?
Mon Dieu, such a powerful strike!
Fascinating!
The assassins have trained you well, Duncan. You chose a perfect time to leave them behind.
At great risk, I imagine. Betraying the assassins is never good for one's health.
Well, neither is drinking liquor, but I am drawn to its dangers all the same. And what is your business here, sir? Are you an associate of the governor's, or a pending acquaintance like myself?
Guns, blades, cannons, grenados. Anything that may kill a man, I am happy to provide.
A smuggler of sorts.
And how is your wife these days, Captain Rogers? Is she, here, in Havana?
I trust she's well, but I wouldn't know. I've been in Madagascar some 14 months hunting pirates. It took some work to dislodge the criminals there, but we managed it. In future, I hope to use these same tactics throughout the West Indies.
And how did you deal with that kind?
Very simply. Most pirates are as ignorant as apes. I merely offered them a choice. Take a pardon and return to England, penniless, but free men. Or be hanged by the neck until dead.
Oh. I imagine Nassau would be your next target.
Very astute, Duncan, indeed.
Best of luck with that.
Grandmaster Torres! Mr. Duncan Walpole has arrived.
See. You were expected 1 week ago.
Apologies, Governor. My ship was set upon by pirates. We were scuttled. I arrived only yesterday.
Unfortunate. Forgive my caution, but were you able to salvage from these pirates the item you promised me?
Yes, sir. I was.
Increíble. The assassins have more resources than I had imagined, but not nearly enough to deter us. It is a pleasure to meet you at last, Duncan. You are most welcome. Come, gentlemen. We have much to discuss. Convened at last, and in such continental company. England, France, Spain, citizens of sad and corrupted empires. But you are Templars now. The secret and true legislatures of the world. Please, hold out your hands. Mark and remember our purpose. To guide all wayward souls till they've reached a quiet road. To guide all wayward desire till impassioned hearts are cool. To guide all wayward minds to safe and sober thought. By the Father of Understanding's light, let our work now begin. Decades ago, the Council entrusted me with the task of locating in these West Indies a forgotten place our precursors once called the Observatory. See here. Look upon these images and commit them to memory. They tell a very old and important story. For 2 decades now, I have endeavored to locate this observatory, a place rumored to contain a tool of incredible utility and power. It houses a kind of armillary sphere, if you like. A device that would grant us the power to locate and monitor every man and woman on Earth, whatever their location. Only imagine what it would mean to have such a power. With this device, there would be no secrets among men, no lies, no trickery, only justice, pure justice. This is the Observatory's promise, and we must take it for our own.
Do we know its whereabouts?
We will soon, for in our custody is the one man who does, a man named Roberts, once called a sage.
It has been 45 years since anyone has seen a true sage. Can you be sure this one is authentic?
We are confident he is.
The assassins will come for him.
Indeed they will. But thanks to Duncan and the information he has delivered, the assassins won't be a problem for much longer. All will be made clear tomorrow, gentlemen, when you meet the sage for yourselves. Until then, let us drink. Let us find the observatory together. For with its power, kings will fall, clergy will cower, and the hearts and minds of the world will be ours. Rest well, Duncan. Tomorrow, the treasure fleet arrives, and with it, your reward. After which, we will discuss further schemes.
I look forward to it.
Excelente. Meet me down at the docks first thing tomorrow morning.
Governor Torres requests your presence at the docks near the Castillo. First thing tomorrow morning.
perdidos.
I think you'll beat that. Put it close with that one. Satisfied with that. That'll do. Satisfied with that. That'll do. Put it close with that one.
¿Sí? Eso sí.
Espero que sean de los antiguos. No soporto la nueva faja ni el corte moderno.
¡Para! ¡Tú! ¡Alto ahí!
Good morning, Duncan. Just over here.
Edward! Hello, Edward! I found a man to purchase my remaining sugar! Huh? Quite a coup, I must say!
He just called you Edward.
Oh, that's the merchant who sailed me here. Out of caution, I gave him a false name.
Ah. Well done.
We'll catch up on it later.
Very punctual, Duncan. This way. Here he is. A man both Templars and assassins have sought for over a decade. I am told your surname is Roberts. Is this so? You recognize this, I think.
According to old tales, the blood of a sage is required to enter the observatory.
We have the key. Now we need only its location. Perhaps Mr. Roberts will be eager to provide it. Transfer him to my residence.
Such a fuss over one man. Is the observatory really such a grand prize?
See.
The observatory was a tool built by the precursor race. Its worth is without measure.
Precursor race? I see.
One of your early letters mentioned a desire to kill the Mayan mentor, Atabai. Were you able to carry out this contract before coming here?
I was not, no. Too many complications along the way.
A pity. But the maps you delivered with the blood vial will see that job finished.
Aye. That's the idea.
I don't like this route, Torres. We're exposed. Something is wrong. Stay close, Grandmaster.
I feel it too. Do not let them get their hands on the sage, at whatever cost.
Assassins! Above! They're on the rooftops!
Watch the street and alleys. They could be anywhere.
Assassins! Above! They're on the rooftop!
Yeah.
You're a nimble one, I'll give you that. Hang back and make this easy on both of us, mate. Or I'll kneecap you.
Well done, lapdog.
Quiet.
We'll see him to the prisons, Grandmaster.
Double the watch.
Well, I'll be buggered. What an active day we've had, gents.
See, he's set on all sides by our enemies. We must be more cautious.
I do wish I could remain to see our drama done, but I must avail myself of these winds and sail for England.
By all means, Captain, speed and fortune to you.
With luck, I'll return myself a governor. And with my idiot king's blessing, no less. Adios.
As for you, Mr. Walpole, I consider this the first payment in a long-term investment. Gracias.
Obliged.
I would like you to be present for the interrogation tomorrow. Call around noon.
Yes, sir.
From the deep there, Captain. Jack thanks you hardy.
Gracias. Vuelva cuando quiera.
Probado un trago y ya está borracho.
Sig me for this pittance. 1,000 reals for those maps. That's what? £100 at most. How's a man supposed to become rich in these times with a miser like Torres running the world?
Have you ever, you ever worked on a plantation before?
You know what I'm thinking? I'd like to see this observatory the governor's going on about. He said it were like a device that could follow people around and show where they were.
A ludicrous idea. Imagine my wife with such an advantage over me.
And imagine what a thing like that'd be worth. Sell that to the right person and I'd be the richest pirate privateer in the West Indies. I'll catch you up, Bonnet. There's a sage in that house I must speak to in private.
Okay.
¿De verdad vas a intentar escapar de nosotros?
Ya basta, sigamos con la ronda.
¡Basta ya!
What is your true name, Rogue?
It's her. Captain Pissoff.
Bianco Pov Pizzo.
Where is this sage? You set him free.
I had nothing to do with that. Much as I wish I did.
Take him to the ports. Send him to Sevilla with the treasure fleet.
Wait now! I delivered your treasures, didn't I?
You did, yes. But you robbed us of Duncan Warble.
A despicable display. This tusspot is a ruined man, Caroline. Unfit for life on land, much less at sea. If he goes to the West Indies, it's you who'll suffer.
Father! Father! Come, love. Up with you now.
That old muckworm! He's wrong about me!
I hope it's so.
You believe me, don't you? Can you not see me? Standing out there on the deck of a ship that's sliding into port. And there I am, a man of quality. With a thousand doubloons spilling from my pockets. Like drops of rain. I can see it.
La cena. Cómetela rápido.
You hungry?
Now what's your plan, mate?
Find the weapon and kill it.
Que Dios nos ayude. No me gusta la pinta de esa tormenta que se acerca.
Parece que se está desviando al oeste, hacia el golfo. Quizá estemos a salvo.
Soldier!
Unlucky lads. Christ, the seas are uneasy today.
Hurricane coming!
Hurricane? Jesus.
Stealing a brig. Hey, take what you need.
Won't be a minute.
There's many prisoners held on these ships. Set them free, and they'll sail with us, no question.
So that's the idea, then. Free what men we can, then find a fast ship to flee in.
Aye, there's a brig in this fleet. I'll make my way to it.
dejaremos escapar.
There's a catch to this favor. You're sailing with me.
I'd follow you to hell for this, mate.
Come on, lads. If we're to drown today, it won't be here. There's a brig nearby just waiting for us to take her.
locura.
Cálmate, no pasará nada. En unos minutos partiremos.
¡Allí está!
¡Deja de retorcerte, pirata! ¿Me entiendes?
¡No te mu-
Going topside. Be ready.
Jagabats. It's a hard wind coming.
The man speaks true. You lot weigh anchor. As for the rest, half on the foremast and half at the main. Let's outrun this hurricane.
Watch on those galleons. See they don't give us trouble.
They won't. Far too slow for this weather.
Bark any orders you think wise, mate. We're up against it here.
These men know their place. They'll see us home.
Let themselves exposed!
Make your fire!
That clown
careful, Captain! He fires many volleys!
Fire!
That's where the most end
is! Fire!
Easy prey for us, Captain!
Fire!
Bloody missed!
It is firing!
There'll be more of the docks, sir!
Fire!
Take the hit!
Fire.
One more direct hit, and we're full of things!
Fire!
Keep watch on those galleons! See, they don't give us trouble.
They won't. Far too slow for this weather. These men, they'll see us home.
Hold down!
Incoming fire!
loose and trim too!
Lay off the loose men!
Incoming fire!
All ship incoming, Captain! Next season!
More sail! All sail! Incoming fire! Brace for impact!
Look out, man!
I see it.
Looking good.
Steady as she goes, man. Not be far now.
By God, we pulled this one straight from the teeth of Neptune. I'm Edward. Much thanks for your aid back then.
Aduwale.
Ever been to Nassau, Aduwale?
Not yet.
By God, she took some knocks, didn't she? I think I'll keep her.
All hands aft, lads! Taking this one home.
I've made my choice, Addy. I'm calling her the Jackdaw.
A sly bird I loved as a child back in Swansea.
A dark little creature, no?
Did it rub you wrong when I took this brig as mine own?
It was the sort of rub I have learned to endure, sailing among faces of such fairness.
It's true. Most of these men wouldn't accept you as a captain. So what fair role would complement such unfairness?
I'll be your quartermaster. Nothing less.
All right. And as quartermaster, have you any immediate counsel for this Tyro captain?
Rest and repast would do us good before Nassau. Water for drinking. Hunting for food and repairs.
Well reasoned, sir. Hunting, it shall be. We'll find a decent place to drop anchor.
I spied a few items in the hold earlier. Powder and a few pistols. I think I'll fashion a second holster if I can.
It's a good start.
One you find laughable.
Could we talk a moment about the condition of the ship?
What's the trouble?
I had a walk about the gun deck this morning and couldn't stand for what I saw. A clutter of linstocks heaped like tinder, and one with a slow match still burning.
Christ.
And just nearby, two barrels of gunpowder, closer than man and wife. Fit to explode at the touch of a spark.
We'll stow ours good and proper.
As for the cannons, they might as well be tossed. Clogs, touch holes in need of scraping, corrosion on the bodies, barrel swabs as naked as knives, and breech ropes so rotted, I could use them for knitting yarn. The short of it is, we need good equipment kept in fine condition. But we cannot win every battle with snares and shouts. So worry about your own armament when it suits you. But don't forget about your jackdaws.
No, indeed. We'll make it a point to keep this ship and its crew in fine condition.
Like true British sailors, we'll rant and we'll roar. Call on the salt seas, and we'll strike soundings in the channel of old England. From ocean to sea, 35 leagues. Now let every man drink off his full bumper. Now let every man drink off his full glass. We'll drink and be jolly and drown melancholy. And here's to the health of each true-hearted lass. We'll rant and we'll roar like true British sailors. We'll rant and we'll roar all on the salt seas until we strike soundings in a channel of old England. From ocean to city is 35 leagues.
Ease off the wind! Haul it all sail!
Ahoy aloft!
Bring it all in!
Clews down! Tank some wind!
Get up those shrouds! Let's move!
Douse all sail!
Full! Full for all your worth!
Ugh.
captain's trick.
Let out some sail!
Get on that main sheet. Trim to!
On the wind.
Who's all? Hearty like. Foul weather there, Captain. Bring it all, sail, gum and tight.
Thank you.
his is more like it.
Ahoy, Captain. Find what you need.
My needs and wants are oceans apart, mate. But I did fashion myself a new holster. All I need now is a pistol to lie in it.
Yeah. Taken from the holds, just as you said.
Little more than a blowpipe. But it'll do. So, are we rested? Or should we idle a while longer?
Best way, anchor. I think the crew is itching to reach civilization.
You'll find no civilization in Nassau. But it's a fine place to be merry all the same.
Stop it, Captain! Some wrecked cargo adrift here.
Brace yourselves!
Bully in the alley. Sally is the girl that I spliced nearly. Bully dancing bow now.
Help!
Bob, I'm bully in the alley.
Go on, Captain Queernabs. Tell me I'm under arrest.
Tell me!
Damn your breads.
Fly away, boyo. Back to your master.
Aye. We was privateers together before the wars ended. I'll see you ashore.
Thank you.
You heard him, you bastard.
Ready to take the shot!
Right!